At the end of the second century, the Han Dynasty was approaching the twilight of its existence after 400 years of continuous rule. People who felt uneasy with the corrupt government launched a large-scale revolt under the self-proclaimed Grand Master Zhang Jiang. In response, the Han Dynasty sent orders to every province to raise an army and deal with the situation. When he heard this, Guan Yu, driven by outrage against these traitors, joined as a volunteer. Little did he know that doing so was about to change his life forever.
Expect us to fight at the side of green recruits?
To be perfectly frank with you, we never expected this many volunteers to respond to our call. Because of that, we are honored to have been chosen to meet the enemy on the front lines of battle.
What do you mean we're honored? We might as well go and commit suicide. You can get killed fighting on the front lines.
What does that matter? Our purpose remains the same. We will use all our skill to stop this uprising. We require a leader, one that would be an inspiration to the people, one worthy of our loyalty.
Commander Liu Bei, I have brought Master Guan Yu and Master Zhang Fei.
Welcome to our force. I am Liu Bei, a direct descendant of Liu Shang, King of Zhongshan. The Imperial Han has asked us to fight against the rebels. Together, we will answer that call.
Zhang Zhao must be punished for causing this rebellion. One force go east, the other west. We will catch the enemy between us.
So, you're next. I'll crush you.
Come for us to build a new world!
Long live the Emperor!
this trick up. All of these tricks have a source. There should be some kind of altar in their base. Destroy it.
This is an important game for our cause.
Forward! by demolishing the enemy's camp.
You'll crush their spirit to the west.
Do not falter. It is merely an illusion. If you cut down the caster, all fall.
This is an important game for our cause. Master Liu?
This victory, we're only treating the symptoms, not the illness. We're fighting a war against misguided peasants. That will not cure this world of chaos.
Tell me then, what is your solution? What would your duty lead you to fight against?
I'd begin at its very core. It is corruption that ruins the land, a blight that harms the people.
I see. It would please me greatly if I were allowed to help you in this endeavor. A sword of your noble purpose.
Oh. To have even one man such as yourself is worth 1,000.
That sounds like a lot of fun. I'll join in with your cause as well.
Then here, in this place, let us swear an oath of brotherhood that we shall live and fight and die as one.
Yellow Turban Rebellion was suppressed, peace did not return to the land. The eunuchs surrounding the Emperor carried on their corrupting ways, and a plot was hatched to eliminate them. Taking advantage of the disorder, Don Huo was able to seize power, and the realm fell further into confusion. In response to Don Huo's tyranny, Yuan Shao gave an impassioned speech calling for the formation of an army to pull down the tyrant. Hoping to return peace to the Imperial Court, Liu Bei, who had become Guan Yu's sworn brother, determined to enter the war. Following his brother, Guan Yu left for Hulao Gate along with Zhang Fei.
As the leader of this coalition, I, the Honorable Yuan Shao, offer our heartfelt thanks for all the aid that you have given us.
A pack of hyenas steeped in pride and ambition. There is no need to even talk with them to see that.
You say what you think. A very dangerous tendency when you're far from home. In general, mediocre people tend to strive for mediocre goals. Is that not right, Master Guan Yu?
And how is it that you know my name?
As you are so adept at recognizing mediocrity, I pride myself on being able to recognize those of true worth. Will you not sit down for a moment? You're not in a hurry to leave, I hope. I would be honored if you shared a cup with me.
I regret I cannot. Thank you. I have duties which were entrusted to me, and I must see to them. A man of great depth and character. I believe great things are in store for Master Cao Cao.
We shall destroy the traitor and his ilk. Forward! It is up to us to restore order to the Han!
So, you are next! I'll crush you!
I claim another victory in the name of my Lord!
Thank you. hold back for now. However, we shall meet in battle again.
I claim another victory in the name of my brother.
I have come for your head.
Now I will crush you!
name of my brother. Claim another victory in the name of my brother.
You have allowed your pride to overcome your senses. One.
the time. Through the gate!
After Dong Zhuo was defeated at Hulao Gate, the governors began to compete amongst each other for power. Liu Bei and his sworn brothers Guan Yu and Zhang Fei, lacking a base of their own, found themselves the guests of Cao Cao after much wandering. It just so happened that at the time, Yuan Shu was attempting to declare himself emperor. Incredulous at this turn of events, Liu Bei borrowed some horses from Cao Cao in order to punish Yuan Shu. In exchange, Guan Yu remained as a guest of Cao Cao and stayed in Xuchang, apart from Liu Bei.
I request that you stay by my side a little longer, Guan Yu.
My lord, you have chosen to follow the path of principle. Such a pathway is filled with great honor. For me, the path of my own duty is extremely clear. It's to be loyal. Nothing can part me from my brothers.
So, you feel the individual is greater than the path?
I swore a sacred oath with these men, and all my honor commands that I go to them. But I do not leave you so quickly, my lord. I offer you my heart and strength for your battle at Guandu.
He, too, cares about the principles we fight for. I know that is true, but I understand why he must leave.
Hey.
impressive force, Yuan Shao. Have both numbers and talent. I need to plan well to win this conflict.
The larger the beast, the more it needs to eat. An army is a beast as well. The enemy supply base at Wu Chao is their weakness. However, we must not act with haste. Let us defend Bai Meng and Yan Ji, time being, and wait for an opening.
My lord! The enemy is attacking Bai Meng!
Send reinforcements! We must protect it at all costs!
My lord! Yan Ji is struggling under an enemy attack!
Yan Ji is falling. We will have nowhere to go. Send our forces to that area and protect it.
You think to outsmart me? Tell me to be lying.
Ben, we must hold them back! It's do or die!
I claim another victory in the name of my brother! I claim another victory in the name of my brother!
Has anyone gonna come back?
battle in your capable hands.
We are in a most difficult spot.
To think that there would be one who could surpass my might. Chao's camp. Advance through the western woods and hit the camp from the sides.
Come on.
your pride to overcome your senses. One person cannot decide that.
Let me out!
I claim another victory in the name of my brother.
What's that? You say that every bit of our supplies are gone, all put to the torch? I praised Cao Cao's strategy. It was very clever of him. However, Cao Cao has underestimated the Yuan family fortitude.
Wu Chao has fallen.
Let us see how long they can last without a fool.
Now is our chance to defeat Guan Xiao. Forward!
Oh. Yuan Shao's army is doomed to failure. Perhaps the freedom I seek shall be found with Cao Cao.
Here I go. will have to display our strength as well.
The honor of the Guans.
I claim another victory in the name of my brother. Surely these acts repay the debt my brother owed you. Bastard Sound Sound, I will return to my brother's side.
Will you not stay with me? Do you even know where Liu Bei has gone?
Red Hair and I shall roam the land. If we follow the smiles of the common folk, we will find my brother.
I am unable to sway your mind. Well, may your duty never be more than you can bear.
I have merely fulfilled my obligation to my lord.